everyone, it's Carrie, and welcome to the Steampunk Parade. In today's video, my wonderful patrons and I voted on a theme for a custom doll collab, and the theme we chose is steampunk. If you're not familiar with steampunk, I go over it a bit in my last video where I collaborated with Anastasia Custom and Tiamat Creations. We created steampunk characters with Disney animator dolls, so make sure to check those out if you haven't already. In the meantime, I'll show you the steps I took to create my steampunk fairy. Also, stay tuned to the end of this video to see our group photo and get a better look at each of these amazing dolls. I'm blown away by the work they did. Extra special thanks to all my patrons, whether you were able to participate or if you cheered us on through the Patreon feed or in the Facebook group or quietly supported us along the way. I just love my Patreon community. Thank you guys so much. Also, stay tuned to the very end where I show the final looks of my doll. So I decided to do a steampunk fairy mainly because I've been wanting to do wings in this sort of way. I had something in my head that I wanted to bring to life into a steampunk fairy. I looked through a bunch of my bits and bobs for inspiration. I had some steampunk gears and chains and jump rings and things like that. So I just kind of tried to piece together what I wanted to have the wings look like. This is literally the first part of the project that I worked on. If you are one of my patrons, I do have in the reward library a couple, probably two or three wing tutorials, and something very similar to this is one of them, so you'll have a step-by-step in there for this. Basically what I did is use some clear printable transfer paper. It's the sort of like acetate or clear film that you can print on, and I printed a design. I actually had to buy the image from like Shutterstock or something and print that out onto the clear film. Then I'm using some wire, and I use some super glue to glue it down to hold it, but to keep it permanent I'm using this UV resin, and I'm just adding that and using a UV light to cure it. And there's the base of the wings, and I just decided to kind of add some gears to where I felt like there was a balance, and then I wanted to cover up these center areas with some embellishments. Moving over to the costume, I had previously worked on these two pieces, the little top and the skirt cover, for another project, and I didn't use them, so I decided to use them as the base because I really liked the idea. So I decided to use that as like the framework for this costume and just started layering up fabrics of similar texture. These were some sample fabrics I had, and I just happened to have like a few different colors, so I thought they went perfect together. I made her some thigh-high stockings and a ruffle underskirt. Then, using some faux leather for the corset, I cut up some little cuts on either side and stitched those up to look like a corset. Adding some metal brackets in the back for the wings to clip into. Then I didn't think the corset was quite fancy enough, so I decided to add a little belt around the center with some jump rings to make it a little more realistic. So I decided to make my own shoes for this project. I thought that some boots or something, or Monster High shoes, would be a little too heavy. I wanted to keep it a little more simple than that, so I got out my pattern for shoes. And again, if you're a supporter over on Patreon, in the reward library there are some patterns, and I believe the shoe pattern is in there. If not, let me know if you're interested, and I can put that as one of the rewards, some of my updated patterns. Later on, I went back to the costume and added a little bit of more steampunk look by adding a belt and gear to the center. It just didn't look steampunk enough for me, so I added that and needed to pull those gears into the costume. I also distressed it a little bit with some inks. So moving on to the face, I started off with a few coats of Mr. Super Clear, as usual, and starting into the face up. I rooted her with some of my favorite ginger colored yarn, and I just end up giving her some curls at the end, but I'll show that process later. I've been enjoying using a lot of different colors in the face-ups, like blues and yellows and pinks and peaches. And this one, I kind of went a little bit further with it just because of her gray skin tone. I wanted to pull out as much color as I could. So I'm trying to give her an expression here. And again, if you're a supporter over on Patreon, this is the doll that I used for our April close-up clip of the month. And I do a demonstration how I pull out those colors and shades to give her an expression a little more close up. If you want to check out what I have to offer on Patreon, the link is in the description box below. Moving on to the lips, I was real unsure about the color and shape of the lips when I got to this point. So I decided I wanted to give her a sort of look that I give a lot of my Rococo dolls. I'll give them a little bit higher, more centered pout, I guess. Larger lips on top. When I first started customizing, I used a lot of, if I was using a gray doll, for example, I would use a darker gray for the shading. If I used a peach tone doll, I would use like a more rusty, darker color. I'd use a lot of mixing, but at the same time, I'd just be using those kinds of shades for the shading and detail work, or the bringing out different highlights and such in the doll. But as I've grown, I'm celebrating 10 years of doll customizing this year, but as I've grown, I've started using much more color and trying to avoid using any darker shades or especially black in the shading of the face. And I'm really enjoying the results. For the eyebrows, I'm using some pastel first and then shaping that with my micro eraser. And then going back with a very sharp pencil and drawing in those lines. I gave her some highlight dots and now on to the hair. So for her hair, I just combed it out and added a little bit of gel and separated it into sections using my heated chopstick. I go through and give her the curls. I get a lot of questions about this when I do this technique, and how I do it is I use a large flat iron at high heat and set my chopstick in there for a little bit, and I can usually get like 2 curls with it. Now I just styled her in a simple side ponytail and just kind of clipped it up to give her a little bit of a quirky haircut. Added her eyelashes, and there's the final look. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, I'd love it if you gave it a thumbs up and subscribed if you haven't already. Make sure to stay tuned here, and I'm about to show our Patreon presentation so you can get a better look of all the wonderful dolls in the collab. Thank you again to all my patrons. If you're interested in seeing what I have to offer on Patreon, my classes on Skillshare, or my Etsy shop, those links are in the description box below. You can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook, or TikTok. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye!